Hello, and welcome to exercise one of the second exercise set. In this exercise, we will work with an application of the renewal theorem and also check one of the conditions that must be satisfied for us to use the renewal theorem. So let's start by taking a look at the setup that is given in the exercise. We have a renewal process N. And we assume that the inter-arrival time has distribution f, which is non-arithmetic. What we mean by non-arithmetic is basically that the claims do not fall at evenly spaced time points. So when we say that f is non-arithmetic, we rule out distributions, for example, on the natural numbers. It is an assumption that often allows us to make our calculations a bit easier. We also assume about the inter-arrival times that they have a finite mean denoted by lambda to the minus first. That also means that the arrivals, they arrive at the rate lambda. We then define two entities, AT, which denotes the time until the next event, and BT, which denotes the time since the last event. If we draw up a timeline, then we can just easily illustrate what AT and BT stand for. So if we consider any time point T, standing there, we have the time of the previous arrival and the time of the next arrival. What AT and BT stand for are, well, AT stands for the time that elapses between now until the next arrival, and BT stands for the time that elapsed between the last arrival until now. Now, in order to apply the renewal theorem, which we will do a bit later in this exercise, we must recall two results that we got from last week's exercise, where we showed that the probability of AT being greater than X satisfies the renewal equation, and we also showed that the probability of BT being smaller than equal to x satisfies the renewal equation. And they satisfy the renewal equation in the sense that this probability here is equal to some deterministic function plus the integral from 0 to t of this function itself with respect to the distribution function f. And the deterministic part of this equation that we have here, we found out last week, was given by 1 minus f of x plus t. And this is also what we call z of t when we talk about renewal equations. It's what we call little z of t. Okay, so the corresponding renewal equation that we found for the probability of BT being smaller than or equal to x, well, that was 1 minus f of t multiplied by the indicator of t being less than x, and then we add the customary convolution between our function of interest and the distribution function. And in the case of this renewal equation, well, this part here is what we call little z of t. So here we have two renewal equations. In the upcoming videos, we will do the exercises that are specified in exercise one, where we will show that each of these zt's are directly Riemann integrable, and We will also try to find the limits for t tending to infinity of these two things.